I got that drip, drip, ay, drip, drip. Baby girl, I got the drip, 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 drip. She say she like me cause the drip, drip, drip.
So my teacher gave us a presentation and she instructed us to come up with goals that we will accomplish during the next 4 years here at FAMU. So what you'll find is the 4 years from top to bottom. So this is freshman, sophomore, junior, and senior. And then across the way, you will find summer, fall, and spring. So first, I want to start by saying that I am from Miami, Liberty City, Little Haiti area. That's where I grew up. Usually, my family just stays in the Miami area, and all of this is like surreal to me. Like, I imagine that I would be going to Miami-Dade, I would not be coming to college, and all of this is just like so crazy to me, and I'm still trying to take it in every day that I'm like more than 400 miles away from home. Okay, so one of the main things that I have on my board is traveling, and you will see traveling twice. I want to study abroad, and I also want to travel with the Peace Corps to help people. The Peace Corps is an organization that I found out about like a year ago, and they told me, you know, I would go in, I would help the people out in their country, I would live their everyday life, and when I come back, I would get a stipend. But the stipend is not what's important to me. What's important to me is getting out there and helping these people and traveling around the world to see what's really out there. The next thing that I would say is my bright pink board. So I feel like the bright pink symbolizes my future. If you notice, everything else is in black and white. I haven't accomplished any of the things that's in black and white. But for my one thing that I did accomplish before this assignment, you will find it at the top, and it's auditioning at FAMU. So the bright pink will represent my future because I feel like I have a bright future. So one fact about me is that I am Hispanic. Here you can see Ishabi. The B stands for Ballesteros. I grew up in a two-parent home. Yes, I grew up with my dad, and he is a fluent Spanish speaker. Now, I have three brothers, and none of us speak Spanish. So you can find Spanish twice on my board. I want to learn Spanish, and I want to fluently speak Spanish by the time I graduate. I also feel like that would better build my relationship with my dad because, you know, it's not hard for us to communicate because he speaks English, but I just feel like if I was able to execute his language better, that we would be able to connect on different levels that we have never been able to connect on before. So I also want to go back and teach. I feel like arts is not stressed enough. I didn't know that I was into arts until I got to high school, and I feel like that's a problem. I feel like people and children should be introduced to the arts because I just feel like it makes you an all-around better person. Like when you have something to do and you feel like you have a role, it makes you learn how to be more of a team player. I just feel like children should learn these things. Like it's very essential theater. Also, I would say that the butterflies symbolize me spreading my wings. And I want to give a shout out to my high school teacher, Ms. Harris, because she showed me that I can be a good leader and also a great performer. And I feel like I would have got to that level, but not as expedited as I did, because she really sat down to me and she talked to me and she told me she wants to see me in a leader position. And I actually worked for it and I got it because I was the president over my troop when I was in high school. And I feel like the relationships that I created with the other students and with my ensemble, I feel like it made me a better person, you know? It showed me that I could be a great leader because these people still look up to me till this day. I kid you not, like, I talk to them all the time. Like, it's really great. And I feel like, you know, I really appreciate her for giving me that opportunity. And the last thing that I want to share with you guys is this painting that someone drew for me. It was a guest speaker that my cousin had at one of his homeless shelter giving back events. It says, "Aisha, let your light shine." So I brought this to college with me because I wasn't always as, you know, outgoing. And I feel like this is what keeps me going. It keeps me motivated to know that somebody sees it in me, you know, like, it just keeps me going. You can see the little bird on what I would assume is like a perch of leaves. Let's take a look at that. So like I was saying, I wasn't always outgoing. I used to be shy. I would have never guessed that I would end up doing something like this. Like, I always thought I wanted to be a nurse. And I thank God I'm not a nurse and I'm gonna be an actress, because I really feel a deep connection with the arts. Thank you for watching.